I'm Maria, and today we are going over everything you need to know about the WordPress image sizes. WordPress image sizes are more complex than you might expect. It's essential to understand how image sizes work in WordPress, what the default image sizes are, and how to define custom image sizes to manage your website effectively. In this video, you'll learn everything you need to know about WordPress image sizes. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Excited? All right, let's go. Uploading images to WordPress is pretty straightforward, but a lot goes in on WordPress's backend as it handles them. The first thing WordPress does when you upload an image is creating three different sizes of your image. It means you end up with four images for every one that you upload: thumbnail, medium, large, and original size. WordPress creates all these different sizes to serve your images in the most appropriate size for each visitor. Your website will always show the correct images to your readers based on the device they're using, speeding and enhancing their experience. You could always edit your images manually to provide these additional sizes, but to do so accurately in a tool like Photoshop is no small undertaking. It will involve a good deal of tedious work, which is why WordPress saves you the trouble. As far as your admin panel is concerned, WordPress stores your upload images in the media library. You can view all your uploaded images by hovering your mouse on the media option and clicking on library. You can sort them by media type and date. However, do note that you'll only be able to sort the images by date if you haven't disabled this function in settings. There's also a search box on the right to help you track down your uploaded image. Just type in a word you used in the title, caption, or description of your image to locate it. Your images are stored in your site's uploads folders. To access this folder, you'll need to use an FTP or SFTP client. There will be multiple subdirectories within your site's uploads folders housing your images by upload date. You can also create custom folders for your media files, but we recommend doing this only if you consider yourself an advanced user. When it comes to WordPress and image sizes, we're always looking at four different ones, with your original image file in the three different sizes WordPress creates by default: thumbnail size, 150 pixels, medium size, max width and height of 300 pixels, large size, max width and height of 1024 pixels, and full size, the original size of your image. You'll want to upload your images in 1024 pixels if you plan to use only these default image sizes. That will allow your images to be served correctly even at the largest size, which may not be possible if your image is of smaller size than the largest size WordPress is using, which is 1024 by default. While the default WordPress image sizes work well for most users, some users may have different requirements. You may prefer a slightly larger size for your thumbnails or a smaller size for the large images. Changing the default image sizes in WordPress would make sense when you find yourself editing most of the images you're uploading because of WordPress's default image sizes aren't suitable for your use case. Before adding new custom image sizes on top of the default image sizes, be aware that you would be storing many more image files on your site's database than you need to. That may lead to performance issues for your site in consuming more space than it needs to. The same goes for image-based sites that need to stick to specific image sizes. Photographers, designers, and others serving up heavy images like to have consistent sizing everywhere across the site to ensure uniformity. Similarly, some landing pages also need to display particular image sizes, and the default WordPress image sizes may not be suitable. And an e-commerce store typically needs to use larger thumbnails, which reveal more detail. Here's a step-by-step process for changing default image sizes in WordPress. Step one, hover your mouse over settings and click on the media option that appears. Step two, change the sizes to what you want by editing the figures. Step three, click on the Save Changes button at the bottom. Now, all the images you upload from this point would be in these new default sizes. Some tutorials out there suggest that you input 0 for the default image size. However, we recommend against this, even if it may help you save on space. If you change these values to 0, then WordPress will use your full size, the original image, in all locations and across all devices, which would lead to a massive spike in bandwidth usage on your site. Further, this would almost certainly slow down page load time for sections that display many of these images. If you need to change all your past WordPress images to these new sizes, you can use several great plugins. For users who tend to use many different types of images, it may be essential to have more image sizes than the 3 default sizes WordPress offers. The default image sizes may be enough for the standard types of images, but for something like pop-up graphics, widgets, or slider pictures, you're probably going to need more image sizes. Custom image sizes grant you the flexibility to improve the functionality of your WordPress site and save a ton of time resizing your images one by one. Now that we've established that as our baseline, let's take a closer look at the process involved in adding these custom image sizes to your WordPress site. You have 2 options here. The first is to use a plugin that handles everything for you with just a few clicks. The second is the manual way of adding the required code strings to your site's files. Let's get to the plugin method first. The Image Regenerate and Select Crop plugin goes beyond regenerate thumbnails, allowing for more customization and functionality. On top of letting you change the default image sizes, it also enables you to regenerate any existing images to match your preferred image sizes, set default cropping options for pictures, and regenerate thumbnails. Once installed and active, you can create as many new custom image sizes as you want via the standard WordPress settings and then media page. Although it's a relatively simple and easy process, the very first thing you should do is create a backup of your website in case something goes wrong while making these adjustments. Once the backup process is completed, head over to the admin dashboard for your WordPress site. Once there, hover over the appearance menu option and choose editor. This may be named Theme Editor in some cases. Next, find the function's PHP file and check whether the following code is already there. Use the search function to locate it quickly. If it's already there, you don't need to do anything. If it's not there, you need to add this string to the file. After you add this code, click on the Update File button at the bottom to activate the function that allows you to create custom image sizes. Now it's time to add the code for the specific custom image sizes you want. Look for the Add Image Size string in your function's PHP file because that's where you'll need to do your edits. Specifically, you should update what's inside the single quotes with what you want to name your new custom image size. We suggest keeping it simple and descriptive. For example, main post image. After you've taken care of the name, you'll need to declare the image sizes themselves. The first numeral value is the image width, while the second is the image height. Here's a screenshot showing our sample code added to the function's PHP file. When an image is made smaller without cropping, it's just a shrunken down version of the original. However, when it's cropped or cut, the cropped portion is removed from the finished image. It's precisely like physically cutting up a picture. If you take your scissors to a portrait and snip out everything below the person's shoulders, you've cropped that picture. It works the same way digitally. The aim is to reduce an image's file size, as cropping isn't the right choice. You'd be removing elements you may want to keep while maintaining a large file size. That said, cropping may make sense for image sizes that have to fit a specific dimension perfectly, like featured images or profile pictures. The main subjects may get too small for something like featured images. They should still get the exposure they need when resized without cropping. So figure out what works best for the different types of images you use and set the cropping feature accordingly. When adding custom image sizes, you can make WordPress automatically crop the images based on the size you set and the original size. You need to add true at the end of the code. Again, here's our example with the cropping feature enabled. However, if you don't want to crop the images, you can either put false instead of true or leave out both. Not putting either of them will make the code automatically assume the false option. That way, WordPress won't crop your images. after you've created the custom image sizes you need, you also need to update the code in your theme. Doing this will make your theme display these custom image sizes as you desire. If you're a complete beginner at editing code, please create a backup of your site again before performing this. Now, you need to find your theme file in the posts loop and add the following code to it. To find this file, click on Theme Editor under the Appearance setting. Look for the index.php file here. This is the theme file that houses the post loop you need to edit. Once you've found it, add this code as seen here. Again, it would be best if you replace the new homepage feature portion with the name of the custom image size you've created. Once you've added this code and updated the file, you'll see the custom image size in your media library. Upload a new image to try it out. While creating and adding custom image sizes feels great, it leaves you with another open task. What about all the old images you've already uploaded? Don't worry about that. Some great WordPress plugins come in very handy for this task. Let's see how they can help you take care of those old thumbnails. Regenerate Thumbnails allows you to automatically re-upload the images in the new sizes, including any custom image sizes you've added. To install it, hover over the plugins menu option and click Add New. Then type Regenerate Thumbnails into the search box. Install the Regenerate Thumbnails plugin by clicking on its Install Now button. After installation is complete, click on the Activate button to start using it. Next, hover over the Tools menu on the left and click on Regenerate Thumbnails. You can click on Regenerate Thumbnails for all attachments to produce new image sizes for all your old images as well. Be careful about checking the checkbox for deleting thumbnail files for your old unregistered sizes, as you can end up with broken images on your site if it still has old images of sizes you no longer use. Regenerate Thumbnails will also list all the image sizes currently active on your site. You may find some image sizes you didn't know. Often, these are created by plugins, especially if they're for improving the look, design, or functionality of your site. As we highlighted before, you should only create custom image sizes you'd be often using. For image sizes you plan on using only on rare occasions, it makes sense to manually edit the image sizes using the WordPress built-in image size editor. We'll give you a quick walkthrough explaining how you can use the built-in editor to edit image sizes quickly and easily. First, click on the media menu to be taken to the media library. Next, click the image whose size you want to adjust. Then, click on the Edit Image button right below the image. You'll see the current image size and can adjust it here. Just put in the image size you want and then click on the Scale button and you're good to go. The size adjustment will automatically save as soon as you hit scale. If you don't like the new image size for any reason, you can always revert to the original size using the Restore Original Image option right below the field for image size. If you're using Gutenberg, you can quickly edit the image size of your images when you add them during the creation of a post. As you can see, when you upload an image when creating a post in Gutenberg, you can select the existing image sizes or change the image size from right within the post option. If you've added your new custom image sizes to your theme file, you'll find them all in the Image Size drop-down menu. You'll also be able to change the image size using the field right below it. All you need to do is input the desired size in the fields, and the image will automatically resize to your new specifications. No image-related guide is ever complete without a mention of image optimization. While we have discussed optimizing images in great detail, mentioning a few quick tips certainly won't hurt. After all, when you're adding custom image sizes, you'll need to know how to optimize your images to ensure they don't affect your site's performance or consume more server resources than they need to. With that said, here are a few quick tips to help you get started with image optimization. Simply choosing the right file type for your image can reduce their size significantly. While there are many different types of image files, the vast majority are either JPEG or PNG. JPEG wins hands down when it comes to colorful images. Also, you can further compress JPEG files to reduce their file size with only a slight reduction in their quality. On the other hand, PNG usually becomes a better option for drawings, text, most screenshots, and graphics. Resizing images is a quick and easy way to reduce the file size of your images. As a rule of thumb, you should make sure all images on your site are only as large as they need to be. If your website's maximum width is 1200 pixels, it doesn't make sense to have a single image on your site with a width larger than that 1200 pixel maximum. We've also mentioned the importance of not creating new custom image sizes unless you need to. So keep that in mind as well. Lossy compression is a great way to reduce the file size further after you've already optimized your images using other methods. It means getting rid of some image data, removing which wouldn't make much of a difference to the image quality, but can help reduce the file size considerably. Lazy loading helps you prioritize the loading of images on your site's pages. It loads images in time with the visitor's scrolling of the page. It means the images at the very top will load immediately, but everything below the fold will not load until the user scrolls past the fold. There's more to it, but you'll find it all in our image optimization guide. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.